Which brings us to our next trivia question. And the few folks here from Tighter to Cover who go to weekly trivia might appreciate this. Which of these is not a state nickname for Georgia? Who said State of Adventure? Raise your hand. Wrong. Woofing Cookies actually had a song on our one album called State of Adventure. Anyway, after the band breaks down, a lot of tension is bubbling under the surface, and Harry and Johnny get in an awful fight. A lot of it is a fight about Johnny's relationship with Cheyenne, but also about the complexity of their friendship. Johnny quits the band and goes home to New York. After he leaves, Harry and Cheyenne hook up. Well, they kiss. And they play a gig with Harry as the frontman, and he finally comes out of his shell almost 10 years after that horrible incident. And life is about to go really well for him. But Harry's luck being Harry's luck, they get a phone call that after Johnny got home, he was out running, which is something, a theme he knows throughout the book, and he's hit by a car and loses his leg. The tour ends, the band goes home. Cheyenne is distraught over Johnny, Harry is distraught over Cheyenne. So distraught that he does the dumb thing. He says to her, Cheyenne, I love you. She literally throws up on his shoes. In the end, Harry goes to see Johnny because it's really about their friendship, this book, and they reconcile. The thing that brings them back together, of course, is music. I'm trying to tune while I talk. Is music. So that was the story, right? It ends nice, it was a sort of good, upbeat ending, a kind of dark book. And I was really, really proud of it. I hoodwinked, I mean, was able to convince a publisher to publish it. And thanks to all of you, yes, and to school librarians everywhere, Smart Boys was pretty successful. And I thought, well, what do young adult authors do? They write sequels, right? Because sequels are awesome. Sequels are always great. And so I sat down and started to write the sequel to Scar Boys. And in fact, it was called Scar Girl. And I kind of labored over it for a while. And it didn't go so well. Because it turns out that not all sequels, or not all works of art, are meant to have a sequel. It turned out that Scar Boys was one of those. So I started working on another project, which actually turned into a whole other book, which is being published next January by Bloomsbury, called Life in the Fishbowl. That's for another time. But then I went on to the really fun work of promoting the Scar Boys, which turns out it's a lot of fun. My very first stop was something called the Pre-Pub Club at Anderson's Bookshop in Naperville. Is Becky in the room? Where? There she is. So, do you see Becky in this picture? This is me at the Pre-Pub Club. There's Becky. Hi, Becky. So anyway, at this event, I had the best time, a great time. I was off and running. And at the end of it, this woman comes up to me. Her name is Wendy Houle. She's an eighth grade educator in Naperville. And she says, come here, I gotta ask you something. I said, what? She goes, at the end of the Scar Boys, Cheyenne's pregnant, right? I'm like, what? She goes, well, she sleeps with Johnny. She throws up on Harry's shoes. I'm like, oh. And right then and there, an entire story sort of laid itself out to me. So, Scar Girl was born thanks to Wendy Houle, who is prominently featured in the acknowledgments. So, the story of Scar Girl opens 3 years in the future. The band has hit superstardom, and they're sitting down with a Rolling Stone-type interviewer to talk about their rise to fame. And they pick up telling their story where Scar Boys ends. And yes, the book does open with Cheyenne pregnant. Where the Scar Boys is about the power of music to heal, Scar Girl is about the power of music to break things apart. Every character is dealing with different issues. Harry, the original Scar Boy, is struggling with his love for Cheyenne. Johnny is struggling with his amputated leg. He was a very popular guy, a runner, and he can't figure out who he is now. Richie, the drummer of the band, is struggling with trying to hold the band together. And Cheyenne, which is really the heart of the story, is struggling with her pregnancy. She is desperate to tell Johnny that she's carrying his baby, but she can't. She can't because Johnny is in a downward spiral, because he can't reconcile the boy he was, again, popular athlete and leader, with his injury. Cheyenne can't add to his burden, so she decides to write a song for Johnny. She's going to tell him with a song. So the song is in the book, and with Stephanie's help, I'm going to play it for you now. But I wrote this song long before the Scarlet's. Okay, so this is Cheyenne writing a song about being pregnant and wanting to tell Johnny that she's carrying his baby. When Kristen, my wife and partner, told me that she was pregnant with our son Charlie. Charlie, come up here. Run up here, bud. Run across the stage and wave her. When Kristen was pregnant with Charlie and she told me that, I didn't know how to respond. I was like so excited that I was floored. I think she thought, wow, that was really cool. I took my guitar, went in the other room, and came back an hour later with this song. This photo, this photo to give my boys equal time is of my son Luke. Come on up here. He is wearing a Whoopin' Cookies t-shirt. Run across the stage away. Applause. Anyway, Stephanie's going to read us into the song, just three paragraphs of the book.